Welcome back to Let's Play Scratches. Director's Cut. Blind. And I was watching my video back. Okay, come on, turn. And I saw something. I think it's this first one. Is it? What's the other one? Wait. There's the rope. If you recall, we put a rope through this wall. We don't like to turn. When we do, we turn crazy. So this goes actually outside, fully outside the wall, not through some kind of, you know, space for insulation or whatever. So I was like, I couldn't figure out how to get out. What? How to use the rope. Oh, I think I need to go down one more step. Well, one more. Whatever. Or maybe not. There we go. So yeah, we are going from outside. Not through the wall. Like I originally thought, I think. Just couldn't. I didn't see the rope barely hanging down. I mean, come on. I carefully pondered the situation and thought about what I was about to do. Right, so it's trying to, if you recall, get down into this hidden room that's been, like, bricked off and then covered with wallpaper. Why was I obsessed with that room? Or whatever occurred inside this house, for that matter? I felt a strong urge to go there, even though I was about to risk my life. I decided that climbing down through the window was the only way to get inside the mysterious room, and I resolved to do it. Why don't you risk your life more going down to that basement? The last of my strength, I managed to get inside the mystery room, and mysterious it was indeed. That's where we came from. Huh. The angel was supposedly guarding the room, but it didn't make me feel any safer. Yeah, no surprise there. So there's the bricked up doorway. Goes out to the hall. The creepy wooden horse seemed to be smiling at me. Hmm. Is that a dog? Yeah, it's gotta be a dog. Like a black poodle? Was this their kid's room? Really? Was this picture's actual, their actual kid? Because that's a different dog. I don't know if it's a different kid. Looks, I guess, similar. Or this was a baby. And I don't know who the pictures are of. Okay. Let's see if this spells out anything that I can see. Open. Tobin, maybe? That empty cradle inside such a dirty and neglected room made me feel very sad. Very sad indeed. And there's even letters on the wallpaper. Oh, wait, no, we came out there. Wait. Wasn't this... Didn't I see a closed window as well? No, never mind. It's my mind playing tricks on me. Never mind. Never mind. So I was thinking about even coming through the ceiling. But yeah, that would have been difficult. It seemed as if someone took extreme measures to forget about the existence of this room for some reason. Mr. Blackwood, I presume. The mirror reflects that one picture. Before I open these, I feel like checking everything else first. So these are not of their kid. Their kid didn't grow to be that old. Just... who they thought their kid might turn out to be like, or something. That horse has no ears. It is really creepy looking. I mean, look at the face like that. Alright, so there is nothing else really to look at. Birth certificate. Registration date 9th day of August 1961. Surname Blackwood. Child's first and middle name are blacked out here. Or soot. Smudged. 7th day of August 1961. Right, we killed her in 63, right? Apparently, anyway. Male. Maybe it was Tobin. Mother's first name, Catherine Lydia Blackwood. Maiden name, Dowerton. James Thomas Blackwood, engineer. So telling of even back, I mean, especially back then. You've got her name and her maiden name. And then you got his name. And his occupation. No occupation for her. I mean, she might have had one. In testimony whereof I have New England hereto, subscribe my name and offered my seal of August, 5th day of August, 1961. Registrar General. Okay. So someone really doesn't want anyone to know about this child, and should I completely forget about it as well. I wonder if this member of the family was still around town and would perhaps be able to shed some light upon the past history of the house. I had to find some way of getting in touch with him. Oh, really? I would think he wasn't even alive. It's blacked off. Something happened to the kid. Well, I have a date of birth. Maybe I can go check those newspapers some more. Alright, this bottom one is not actually a drawer. Okay. I guess we're done here. Are we... climbing back up? I need my breath. Hearing his breath like that actually made me kind of nervous. Let's close this. Alright, let's go to the newspapers! Still wonder about the presence in the dark area, which we cannot see. Even with the lantern, I could not see. I looked for any worthwhile news in the editions of May 1963. I looked if there was anything of interest in August 1961. Right, well, this we know. Terrible news. Alright, That's her. From the journal. Sad news hits our beloved town today, following an announcement that was received with rejoicing amongst many that one of the most illustrious members of our community, Mr. James Blackwood, was having a child soon. We now have to relate a macabre turn of events. The son that was being lovingly awaited by the Blackwood family died shortly after the delivery due to a strange ailment. Understandably, the information disclosed about this happening was succinct. It appears that Mrs. Catherine Blackwood was already suffering from pains in her stomach, probably an indication that there was something not healthy about her pregnancy. Dr. Christopher Milton, he was the attending doctor. He stayed upstairs in the room we're staying at. Dr. Christopher Milton, who attended the birth, assured us that he made every possible effort to ensure a safe delivery, but with bowed head, he said that the boy was already doomed ever since his conception. The cause of death has not been stated, but those few close to the Blackwood family have said there were serious complications during the delivery. Helping to relieve that somber news, Mrs. Blackwood was thankfully found to be out of danger. Her husband did not wish to comment about the event. Tour in Central Europe at a meeting. I have these little snippets of stories. A successful ruse. Supervisor? I don't know what that stands for. Jay Keegan, while driving his motor car, was held up by 8 armed and masked men. The leader of the something or other. My huge disappointment quickly gave way to an empty void feeling. Something wasn't right here. I began wondering if James Blackwood was somehow involved with the death of his son. Oops. Now stand by, because I think I have my volume down. For you guys, it probably won't sound any different, but for me it's a little low. Okay. That's better. Alright, so I'm wondering what we do now. Maybe the phone's working again. Let's go check to see if the lines are back up. I'm gonna talk to Jerry. Not call the doctor's office. Or is it the doctor? Or it's the bank. Oh, over here, right. This way, I think. Yes. Wrong way. Just felt like looking here anyway. We have a dial tone. Let's speak with Jerry.
Yes?
Jerry, it's me. You won't believe what I've found here. It's about the happenings that led to the murder you told me about. There's an impressive backstory surrounding this place and many loose ends. It would seem nobody ever stumbled upon this.
Shouldn't you be working on your book?
Are you listening to me? James Blackwood was into some very weird stuff and possibly dangerous.
Possibly.
Something tells me this case is much more complex than it was thought to be.
Why don't you inform the authorities? I'm sure they'll be dying to reopen a long-forgotten case about some crazy old psycho killing his wife.
No way. And miss all the fun? I'm doing this on my own.
Huh.
I wonder if those noises I heard have anything to do with this. Maybe James Blackwood was trying to hide something.
Like in that book, where an old man was guarding the entrance to hell. I bet this James Blackwood person had a doorway like that in his basement.
Huh.
These dreadful noises must be the sounds of the damned coming for you.
Oh, boy.
Why, thanks, mate. That's been very helpful. Great to have friends like you.
Then stop talking. idea how crazy it sounds. You're a writer, not some fancy PI.
I'll get to the bottom of this. I know I will. I'm certain there's much more to James Blackwood than a simple act of murder.
Now you're sounding more morbid than usual. Simple act of murder? Oh, goody. Just somebody died. Nothing to worry about. Like you, Michael. This whole thing is really affecting you.
Stop being a drama queen. I'm a grown-up, and I'm pretty aware of what I'm doing.
Fine. Go chase around the ghosts of James Blackwood. I'll stay here in the real world.
I'll let you know about my progress.
I like Jerry. He's funny as hell. Bother him again? Busy signal? Yeah. I have this distinct feeling that every time he talks to us, he decides to take the phone off the hook for a little while. Barbara. Nope, not on the Sunday, that's right. So what do we do now? What time is that? PM. We still don't want to go outside, right? Nope. Oh, perhaps it was time to do some work. I just felt like checking in here for the doctor's stuff. His note. So he delivered that baby, which died shortly after. The whisperings. Every time I walk past the gallery, the whispers grow louder. They're luring me inside. May God have mercy on our souls. This was his stuff. Alright, so he wants to get some work done. I know there's the book downstairs too. In the room with the piano. But I don't want to go all the way down there and read it again. Look at that. Suddenly, she stopped and stood there, paralyzed, hesitant to give any credit to what her eyes were seeing. Okay, getting some work done, look at that. And completely unaware of the... something... Oh, I can read it easier this way. Completely unaware of the potentially dangerous situation. Surprisingly, there wasn't anything unusual or strange about the event. Little Kathy... was hastily crossing the... You know, Catherine is the name of the mother. Little Kathy was hastily crossing the living room towards the huge oak door, her fancy black dress fluttering at every footstep. As the girl reached the doorknob, she turned to look back at Marion and urged her with a whisper to hurry up. Hurry up. But Marion wasn't seeing Kathy. Her memories haunted her back. If I was an editor, I would change that. What do you mean, her memories haunted her back? And displaced reality. Yeah, that is a different word. Giving room to the nightmare's vision she had spent months trying to forget ever since her first visit to the old house. In her dream, she saw the little girl, also wearing a black dress, emerging from a passageway hidden in the room. She never actually managed to glimpse where the passage was, only saw the girl running towards her, her small face contorted in a horrible grimace. Marion quickly realized it was a twisted version of the Kathy she would know later, as if her figure was then distorted by a veil of smoke. Her exact movements to the room, reaching for the knob, facing her back, those were too many coincidences to ignore. It wasn't a nightmare that she experienced that day, nor a ghost, something she refused to believe in, but was now willing to blindly embrace as the truth given the shocking vividness of the vision. A ghost would come from the past. What she'd seen came from the... Her thoughts were interrupted as a figure behind her cast a shadow across the doorstep.
"You filthy liar!
You have betrayed me!" groaned a deep voice. "The discoveries I had made in the house are too exciting to stop now. I thought that maybe I could investigate further today and return to work tomorrow." Well, that's the other page. Return to work tomorrow. Well, what else do we have to do? Oh, I lay down the bed, okay. Something didn't feel right. Now, the funny thing is, he was talking about exploring the house more, but then we just went to bed. Something didn't feel right. Shall we listen at the fireplace again? Not hearing anything. So something didn't feel right, but I'm not hearing any noises, and I can't stop. Come on! Back to the window! I'm out of the window when that happens. It boots me out. It kind of like alt tabs me out when you see that happen. And then I'm like fighting to get back in the window, back to full screen. Something doesn't feel right. Should we check the gallery? Are we dreaming again? Well, the case is there, still pushed aside like we left it. Oops. Hey, I'm sorry about this, guys. The mask. Oh my god, it's really bad this time. The mask is gone. Did I read both of these? I read this. James. So this is from James to Christopher. Now that I know he was their doctor, like, he tried giving, you know, delivering this kid, puts it in a little bit of a different light. But, well, the mask is gone, and, we don't have anything to say about it. Whoa! Once again, I was awakened during a bizarre dream by those scratching noises. Well, that was a little scary. Not until I figured out what those scratching noises were coming from. Oh, I want to go back to bed. Oh, I was timing and then I stopped because I hate that. I don't know how long I was running. Hopefully this episode is not too much longer or shorter than usual. we'll listen again at the fireplace. I had to find out their source. I had to, mister. Yeah, that was a little nerve-wracking. I gonna see that mask in front of my face again? Should we check to see if it's here now? Before we go down to the other fireplace? Presence made me feel terribly uneasy. It's funny, now we can see it without the lantern and at night. How do we suddenly have all this light where before we did not have any? Oh, the African theme started overriding the sound. Now it's quiet. So we're going to check the other fireplace, like we did before. I had to find out their source. The source of the scratches. Oh, it's the unborn child coming back to life, come to kill you. Well, was born, actually. Briefly. Just looking around. Really just passing through here. Because I guess we're heading for the basement. But the basement didn't work out last time. I think he said he wasn't going down there. But now we have light to see the mass, so maybe you have light to see the basement. The room was too dark to see anything. Oh, brother. Wait, I lit it. I lit the lamp, wait. Oh my god, the flickering from the lanterns is gonna drive me insane. Oh my god, we're going in there. Oh wow. Another hidden room? Whoa! Holy crap! Where is this? Is this leading outside? I can't see anything. Oh. Is that it? There was no way I would enter the furnace again. Why did we go in there in the first place? and a menacing look to it. Wow, that was... there's something... well, there's someone. A drain covering the concrete. I don't know if we're supposed to try to go through there or not. It's somewhat alarming. So what adjoins this room? With my heart pounding, I barely gathered the strength to leave the basement. Barely grabbing the doorknob here. The last drop inside the lamp had been consumed. Should we go out around and see where that is? Where we're looking into? I didn't want to leave the house at this time. It was already chilly enough inside. Huh. Maybe the maid is still around here. Maybe she's skulking about. Either alive, dead, or undead. I'm not sure where that was. Where that was. Somewhere outside, I guess. Not liking the music either. I was too confused to think straight and decided, almost against my will, to return to bed. Monday, October 14th. My third and final day inside Blackwood Manor. Final day? Began with an odd feeling of expectation. Still shaken about the occurrences of last night, I managed to pull myself together and focus on finding out what really happened inside this place. So it's like he's... I had plenty of things to investigate. Something told me I wouldn't have any moments to rest this day. Well, the way he wrote that final day, like, as if he is writing this from the future. No, I knew it was fruitless. I couldn't write. I had to solve the mystery. It was the only thing that mattered to me now. Well, I don't know how long we've been running. I don't think... I have a feeling it might be a shortish episode if I stop now. We should call Jerry and tell him about that. Maybe we can go outside now, too. It was incredibly cold inside the house now. Jerry?
Who is it?
It's me.
The ghost hunter. Any contact with the other world yet?
Actually, I'm not sure. Jerry, I'm definitely not alone in this house.
What are you talking about?
Last night I saw something down below. It was moving. I wasn't dreaming, and I'm not making this up.
Are you sure it wasn't a mutant rat?
Definitely no rat.
Mutant rat?
I'm calling the police.
No, not just yet.
Michael, for Christ's sake, you could have a burglar inside the house.
This is no burglar, Jerry. It's much more interesting than that. And I want to figure this out by myself.
You fool.
Have you taken leave of your senses?
Leave the house
just
now.
Just promise me you won't call anyone. I can do this on my own.
Whatever. Just call me if you need any help. I'm driving there today.
Right. Bye.
You fool. This is the part where you leave the house now. I know your car's broken down, but you go on foot. Just walk. We can talk to Barbara. It's not a Sunday, right? Let's. I was about to dial. I remembered that Barbara said she would take Monday off. We need this translated. That damn Barbara. Alright. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Hopefully this isn't too short of an episode. I seriously considered warming up the place. Alright, so I guess we're gonna start a fire. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.